Hello and welcome everyone to the SFM tutorial series, when I am going to be teaching you on how to use SFM, at least give you my tips on what I do. So basically in this episode we'll be looking at scene building. Now scene building is very useful if you don't have a map that represents what you want to achieve in a scene or in a movie, and you don't know mapping. This is when scene building comes in, which is basically constructing your scene from props. In these episodes we'll be using, for the map, scene building. For the scene building map we will be using Black Void, an enhanced version that is basically larger. We will be using Nary's Sky Domes, and we will be using the Halo 4 Forge props. So let's get started. So first things first, I am not sure what to build. Alright, let's see. Let's give a nice big floor. So, you see, scene building is basically spawning props all over the place and constructing, well, in this case we will be making a small courtyard. Alright, I'm going to cut here and get back to you with the finished work. Okay, so basically I've set up this small courtyard here, as you may see, and yeah, it's very, very basic, but it's just for the sake of the tutorial. So, as you may notice, I have not enabled lighting because this map doesn't have any. So if I turn it on, we just got a black screen with nothing to be seen. Now that's what we are going to, well, combat next. So, let's place a sun. For a sun, you basically want to place a light and, well, go as far as you can. Maybe even out of the map at some cases. Well, I think this is enough because it's rather a small space. Well, keep horizontal and vertical field of view to the minimum, shadow filter size and shadow depth bias to the minimum too, and give the radius a value of 0.02. Alright, well, if I turn it on, it doesn't really do anything. As you see, well, we're out of the map in this case. So let me just disable word brush models. So yeah, there's still nothing to be seen because we're out of the light range. Now what do we do next? What we do is reconfigure. So we remap the slider ranges to, let's say, 50,000 to maximum, both for max distance and for the attenuation. Okay. Now we give constant attenuation a number of, very small number because it's very powerful, so let's say this small. Now see, it's rather nice. Okay, we adjust, and you notice these small artifacts. Well, that is because the min distance is still at default, so let's set it to, let's say, 15,000. Now let's drag it to the maximum. See, small artifacts removed, and the shadows get a bit more detailed, but not in this case. In larger maps and in larger, well, scales, it does make a hell of a lot of difference. Alright, so what I do is basically get shadow attenuation to the minimum, so it's dark shadows, so it doesn't, so the sun does not interfere like this, because that's not something I want. Alright, so basically how this should look in render, you see these small, pixelated shadows, but in the end, in the render, it will look smooth like this. If you enhance the radius, so let's say it's getting 0.05, it gets smoother. Basically, what radius does is move the light around in a small space. Well, the larger the value, the larger the space, it moves it around, and it creates this blurry effect. So the further the shadow is from where, well, alright, so the further the shadow is from where the light, well, basically breaks contact, so can't really explain it, so the further the shadow is, the more blurry. Alright, but this is very dark. What do we do next? Well, we place ambient lights. Well, that's what I call them. So ambient lights are basically our way of simulating reflected lights. What I do is well, get it to zero, the transform, then let's say, let's get it out by, I'm not sure if this is the right direction I want it to go. I believe it's not. Okay, now it's kind of lost. So, yeah, it can be a bit tricky. Let's put it here. And give it, alright, minus 5000. That should do the trick. So, same thing as with the sun, but with the maximum horizontal field of view and vertical field of view. Well, get the maximum distance and far z eton to the, well, let's go with 30,000. That seems like a nice value. 30,000, even though it's just 10,000 away. Alright, so I'm disabling the sun now. Disabling the sun, and you see this small, well, it's very faint. Well, you should disable shadows, because that way, well, objects will be ignored and the light goes through everything. And yeah. So now all you need to do is to adjust the intensity of the ambient light. Alright, I think this looks nice, and the color. So I am going with a bit of a blue shade because it looks just a bit more natural. You can also toy around with the quadratic attenuation, but for me, I use linear. It's much stronger, so you have to work with small values here again. So you see it's 001, but let's go with 005. And then we have more freedom to adjust. Alright, this will still be bright, but who cares? Okay, so basically what you want to do is copy-paste and make it the other way around. And turn it around too. So now you see it's coming from both ways, from the left and the right. But this is not quite enough. As you see, some shadows are still, well, not exactly the way they should look. So what you want to do is turn it, and let's get it out here, 5000, that's quite a decent value, and let's look for, there's our map, and let's turn it by minus 90 and zero the other values. So now it's coming from the front. Now let's put one in the back. So in the back, turn it around. All right. Get a pig's making noise again. And there we go. At least this is basic. So you see now it has this, well, ambient light, as I'd like to call it. It's a constant light all over the place from four sides. And I usually put one above the map too. So let's do it like this. I just have to toy around a bit. See, this is 90, this is 0, and move it up by 5000. See? This is the difference it makes. I'm going to show you just in a second. See? Looks much better. Alright, now let's put one in the bottom, and as you see, as we add light, it gets brighter and brighter, so that's why you need to adjust it after you are done placing them. It's very important. Okay. I think it's minus 90, I'm not sure though. Okay, I think this light... Yeah, it sometimes happens that when you edit like this, some things can get messed up. Not my fault, I don't know why it happens, but it definitely does. Alright, so flip it around. See, this NAN is just not what you want to see, and I'm not sure why it happens again. Pretty weird. Okay, let's turn it around first. Minus 90. And let's move it up. Down. And great. You see how... Well, that it's a slight change, but it is still a change. So now we have, well, somewhat good-looking shadows. I usually group them together and name the group ambient, so it's easier to edit. So I only select the first one since they are all equally far away from the map. I just edit the first one, like make it just a bit more blue and less intense. Let's go with 0.15. And except for the transform, because the transform is well the point the light is coming from. So the position and the rotation, you don't want to copy those values, only the rest. Then copy the samples, click on the group and paste them. And now you see we have this more sky color like shadow light, well, ambient lights. Sorry, my tongue tripped. So what you want to do next is search for this, the sky dome. This is what I use to, well, simulate a sky. So let's place it in 0 and turn it, I believe, here with 90. Nope, it's the first one. So let's turn on the first axis by 90. So as you may see, it's above the map and it blocks our sun, which is there. So what I do is add scale control to models and, well, scale it the hell up. See, now we have, from the inside point of view, it's looking very nice. So I'm going to use a custom sky texture here. I don't know which one it is. So let's just go through. By the way, there are a lot of sky textures. I just modified some. So this is basically having moving clouds. This sky is exported from Halo 4. And set up the sun to the direction that the light is coming from. In this case, it's coming from right there. So I believe, but it's a bit off. It's just a bit off. So let's replace it. Oh, we have to move further and further and further away. Okay. So now we have it accurately displayed. Great. See, now this is a very basic scene build, as you notice, but these rules apply to all scene building that I do. First construct the scene, then the lighting, and then put a sky dome over it. So that closes the whole thing. Yeah, there are some pretty neat skies. Just don't look up because it can get a bit weird. I think it's because the texture turns that way. I don't know. So yeah, changing the sky is basically turn it around. Let's find the sun. I think it's coming from there. So that's where light is coming from. Turn it that way and then adjust the color of your sun. So make it a bit more this. So if you go and create a new camera, which is what I use, I always create an animatable camera because this way I can toy around with the field, well, not the field of view, but, well, where the focus is, etc. So let's focus there. So yeah, it's just looking nice, in my opinion. I don't use motion blur, by the way. I render in 60 FPS and it kinda, well, makes it unreasonable to use motion blur. So yeah, it is a basic scene build, as you may see. Alright, in the next episode we'll be looking at animation from the basics to more complex movements like picking up a weapon, for instance.